Hey everybody, how are you? We've got a dog here that came to us with some human bites, some dog bites, incredible prey drive. So we're gonna do a couple of things. We're just gonna do sort of like, I've got Jessica here, one of my trainers, Spencer, one of my trainers, and I've got, how many dogs do I've got? I've just got three of my own dogs out. So what we're gonna do is this. The dog, we wanna get the dog, what we wanna do is we wanna get this dog out with, not to pay attention to toys that I'm gonna throw. This dog blows off commands for toys. So this is gonna be a live dog training demo here. So the dog, what kind of, I don't know what kind of breed this is. He's probably like a pity mix, like most dogs that come through here. Good, so that's the dog right there. Yep, okay. Okay, so let's do an experiment here. So, let me get Grow with a toy, and then Spence, you heal him around off leash.
Yeah.
And let's see if we can get him to not pay attention to the toy. All right?
Yeah.
Is that another toy the dog? Okay. Girl, here. Girl, here.
Yeah.
Good. Girl, here. Good girl. Out. Nine. Out. Good. Nine. Okay. So this is what we're going to do. This dog loves this toy. So what we're going to do is this. I'm gonna throw this toy across the dog's bow. We'll talk about boats right now. Across the dog's bow. And Spencer's gotta keep him away from chasing the toy. Obviously, dogs love toys. Obviously, we allow him to play with toys. It's not that we don't allow him to play with toys, but right now, I'm gonna have my three dogs, my high energy dogs, run past him for the toy, and let's see if we can keep him focused on Spencer. And excellent job, Spence.
Good,
excellent. Good, good. If you need help with your dogs on Mondays and Wednesdays, I do a Q&A show, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Good job. Okay, let's try that again. You can ask a question about this dog, but I'm not answering any dog training questions. No, the dog's allowed to be obsessed with toys. We have no problem with the dog being obsessed with toys. What we're doing is just we want the dog to listen to a command when there is a high level distraction.
Nope.
That's what we want.
Good boy.
Girl, here. Oust. Good. Okay. Do it again. Can we get better lighting? How do we get him not to break focus? Dog training.
Good boy.
Training. He didn't come in like this. He came in like this, biting humans, biting dogs. And not focused. So that's all training. Massive amounts of repetition by Spencer and Jess and John.
Good.
And we're gonna do that again.
Yeah,
yep. And nice.
Good.
Yep. Catch is closing. We're gonna download everything to YouTube, but we're not sure what's gonna happen because we've got a couple of days of downloads to do. Yep, it's too bad Catch couldn't make it. Dog's been here for 2 weeks. What's Spencer doing with the remote collar? If the dog gets a little bit unfocused, he's probably just giving him a little bit of a tap, tap. Just tap, tap, just to get him refocused. How long does this last? The dog's here for another couple of days. But the dog also would normally get into fights too. Is the dog, other dogs having the toy especially difficult for him? No Nation, I'll let you answer that question. I'll let you answer that question. What do you think? A lot of the questions that people ask, they already know the answer to. What do you think? Yes or no? Should the dog not be closer to you? No, we don't compete. This isn't competition heel. We're family dog trainers. We don't do competition heel. The dog is sort of like in a follow mode. I have no problem with this dog where the dog is right now at all. The dog is actually following him. The dog should not be, remember, it's not that competition-focused heel work. We don't do that. I've never taught it. We've never taught it. I'm not interested in teaching it at all. This is more of just like, okay, here's a good, let's scale this. Wouldn't that be great if this dog walked down the beach with you like this?
Nope. Good boy.
Yep. That's all that we really care about. We don't do anything for score. Who's got the toy? You do. House? Nine? Good. Place? Where'd my other dog go? Here. Place? Nine, place. Okay, let's go swirl around again. And I'll wait till you come back the other way, Spence.
Oh.
Yeah, people can hit the little character in the corner, share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter, share this on Periscope. And
good boy.
Excellent. Good. Good. All we're trying to do is just do a little bit of focusing exercise. Get this dog not to pay attention to the toy. Get the dog not to pay attention to my dogs. That's all we really care about right now. You go in the middle of the room, Spence, so it's easier to film you. Yeah, right in there. Just do drills there. Yep, thank you. Will he still do this with a different owner? Not a different owner, with his owner. He has an owner. So he's here for a boarding training. This is not the owner, this is a trainer. So will he do it with the owner? All depends on the owner. Will we release him to play later? Yep. So now we'll down him and see if he does it. All right? So, aus. And, okay, so now what we'll do is this. This is going to be really hard. So, Spence, back up a little bit, and let's see if this dog will stay in a down while a toy goes by with two racing dogs. So let's see if this works.
Good.
And I'm happy with that. Good. So the dog is learning impulse control. The dog is learning obedience, and the dog is learning how to control, obviously, its impulses, which is impulse control. All right? So I assure you this dog did not come in like this at all. None of these dogs do.
Nope.
Now he's on your time doing what you want. Later he gets to do what he wants. No, I mean, he'll be outside during socialization sessions, but I mean, none of the dogs here get a lot of free roaming. I mean, we can release him right now and see what kind of choices he makes, but chances are he's going to go back into obedience because that's what he's used to here. So dogs don't come here to play. They get play, but nobody comes here to play. Most dogs know how to play. If a dog doesn't know how to play, we'll help them with that. But no owner says, I want my dog to have more energy. Most people are like, my dog's out of control. Stop him from, you know, all the nonsense that he's doing. So why don't you just release him, let's see what the dog does.
Great.
All right. He's probably going to default to an obedience command, though.
Yeah, he still wants to follow me.
Yeah. If your dogs fight, that's a Skype session. If your dogs fight, keep them for now, keep them separate, and keep them safe. But I can't fix your fighting dogs on Periscope. How well do they transition back to the owner? It all depends on the owner. All depends on the owner. If it's a strong owner, ouch. But if it's a strong owner, the dog will do well. If it's a soft owner, the dog will struggle. So the dog's in free mode right now, and great. But the dog's gonna default back to sort of like, I'm supposed to be calm hanging out with these two humans. Great job. Great job, Spence. Great job, Jess. This is great. The dog bites strangers. Yep, that's Ronan. Yeah, he just like does his own thing. If you want your dog to be like this, start teaching your dog the basics. Teach your dog the basics. And this is the first time that I've hung out with this dog.
Good night. Here. Good boy, buddy.
Yep.
Good job.
Yep. Yep. But he's got a personality. I mean, the dog runs around. But this is our training room, so. This is called Climb, K-L-I-M-B. Go to blue-k9.com, blue-k9.com. Each one of these is an individual, individual stair. Girl here. Girl here. Climb. Good. Break. Good job. It was a blue9.com. Thank you very much. Thank you. Good. Buck's doing great. All right. Jess, will you help me scoot this up higher? Ready? Let's move it over. There we go. Good. Let's see if I can get girl on this. Girl here? House. Dying. Okay. Knock it off, guys. Let's see if I can get one of my dogs to climb this. Come here. Everyone loves to see this stuff. Girl, climb. Oh, there you go. Up, get up there. Try it again. Girl, here, climb. Oh, look at that. Wait. Nice. That's very steep. Yep. So this is it. Let me see if I can make it steeper without tipping over. I'll do that again. Girl, here. Ready? Look out here. I'll just give everybody scale. I'll scale this. This is pretty steep. So let's try that again. Here. And climb. Good girl. Break. Good. Jess, it's your turn. Climb. So that's it for today. That's it for now. Looks like we created some good impulse control with this dog. Dog's doing well with its obedience. This is made. We make all our own wooden stuff. So, questions about this at all? Questions about this training protocol? All we're doing is we got this dog to be stop being so reactive around dogs, stop being so reactive around people, and impulse control is huge. The dog loves toys. I assure you, if this dog goes to the park with a ball, with a toy, it's gonna run around like crazy. We didn't stop the dog's prey drive. We just controlled it. That's all we did. And right now we're just telling the dog we don't want you chasing things. Do we have a video detailing it? Not really. I mean, just watch all our training videos. So if you and your family have got different things with your dog, well then you're gonna struggle for a long time until you're on the same boat. Take girls to climb. Call over there.
Girl, here.
Here. Nice. All right, that's it. Gonna head out. What's the first thing we taught this dog? Probably to walk on a leash, thresholds, going in your kennel, going into the kennel. Thresholds, place command, walking on a leash properly, down, sit. Do one more time. People love that.
Girl, here. Girl, here. Climb. Break.
Good. All right, everybody. Thanks a lot. We'll do a little Ronin cam. All right. Take care, everybody. Love you all.